Dipple, what is your business?
Speak plainly. Not the words for a politician.
We are all aware of your influence, Mr. Dipple, but in the seat of government, you would do well to address me with the customary respect.
Sir Robert, spare me the indignation of tradition. We are both men of the modern world. Governments come and go, like the passing of the seasons. And yours is in trouble.
What is your business? Fox, would you be so kind as to collect the minutes of this morning's cabinet meeting? Thank you.
There was a murder 2 nights ago in Westminster.
The Archdeacon.
And that night also saw the escape of a dangerous lunatic from Bethlehem. His liberty is of concern to me.
And why should it concern me?
I understand your new cemeteries bill reaches a crucial stage.
As we have discussed. Mr. Dibble, your support for this scheme is very generous.
Yes, I believe the swift apprehension of this man will hasten the completion of these documents in no uncertain measure.
And what will you gain from this?
Me?
You hardly impress us the Good Samaritan, Mr. Dipple. Very well. I can assure you that the Metropolitan Police will consider the arrest of this escaped lunatic to be a matter of the utmost urgency.